Linked lists are super awesome. You hear about them here and there, but do you know how to create one, to build one from scratch? Well, today I'm going to show you just that. So if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Now let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. On one of my previous videos about data structures, where I showed you how you can create a stack, I have told you that if I get at least 15 likes on that video in the first 3 days, I will create a new video about linked list. So here we are. Today we are going to learn about linked list. Before we dive into the video, let me just remind you about DevFactory, a 16-minute Zoom call with me where you can ask me anything about Swift, Swift UI, or I can help you with your bugs in your code, or I can even teach you how to use Swift UI efficiently in your project. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and check out redeveloper.com/mentoring. Before we dive deep into the tutorial, I'd like to give a shout out to WebView Gold. They are the sponsors of today's video. With WebView Gold, you can convert your web app or website into apps for iOS and Android. All you have to do is set up your URL and you're done. Optionally, you can add push notifications, ads, and even in-app purchases, plus a ton more. If you have a website and want to launch your app on the App Store, check them out. The link is in the description. Save 25% with their back-to-school sale. Now, let's get back into the video. So let's dive into today's topic, and that is linked list. And we are going to talk about simply linked list, doubly linked list, and circular linked list. Now, we are not going to cover everything, but in the resources, you will find everything there. Now, we are going to start off from a beginner's level, and we are going to build out a linked list. But what is actually a linked list? So go ahead and check out the resources on the description where you can find all of these files. And you can download them. Yeah, you should download them because I do have a lot of starter files for our project today. But before of that, we add them to our project, let me just show you what this linked list is about. So let's just move this into our window. Yes. So what is actually a singly linked list? Well, think of it as an array, but much, much better actually, in terms of performance, actually much, much better. And you have to learn a little bit about the jargon about linked list. First of all, linked list might be empty and so forth, but if they do have some elements, they are called nodes. So this is a node, this is a node, and these are three nodes. Each node has a value and the reference to the next value. So next, next, next. And the last value has a reference of nil. Now, the first element is the head, and the last element is called the tail. So that is what you want to remember. Now, for the doubly linked list, let me just show you that also. Let's just open this up and scale it down. There we go. So this is our doubly linked list. It's also the other way around. So we do have a next value, but we also have a reference to the previous one, as you can see. Also, the head will have a nil previous, and of course, as in the singly linked list, the tail has a nil value for the next. Now, for the circular linked list, it's the other way. So the next value will be the first, so the tail will just be referencing the head. So also the head will reference the tail as the previous. So that's kind of that. Those are kind of rare to use. Also, doubly linked lists take up double of memory because it has a reference to the next value and also to the previous value. But just so you know, these are the doubly linked list and this is the singly linked list. You can find this in the resources. Okay, so we are going to build out the linked list, and in the resources, you will have a singly linked list file and also a doubly linked list file, which is a little bit more extra. It has a lot of extra functions that I'm not going to talk about in this video because they are kind of self-explanatory after we create the linked list. Okay, so I've already prepared a starter project. It's just a vanilla starter project. So let's just create here. Let's just drag and drop, first of all of our needed files. And as you can see here, we have our content view. So we are just going to remove that. So let's delete our existing content view, move to trash. And now all we have to do is select this one, these, and also this one. Okay, just drag and drop them right over there. And there we go. So in the content view, it's just displaying the list description in, as a text. And we may delete last and append. And you will see there are a lot more for these in the singly linked list and the doubly linked list files. But for now, let's just talk about this file. So you see that we have a linked list node and a linked list. As of course, it has a lot node and itself, so the linked list. And we can see here something called the T. And what is that T? Well, we are going to use generics for the linked list because we might have a linked list of integers, string, and other types of elements. So you can take a look at the generics example right over here. So do something value int, and we are going to return that value, value string. So the easiest way to do this is just add in here a T, like we have it or here, or on the struct itself, and then we can reference this, and T could be anything. Also, you can just add in here dot codable, and that would be T will be accepted only if that is codable. But yeah, basically that's it. You can take a look at the language guide for Swift under generics at this link. So go ahead, click on that if you do want to learn more about generics, and also take a look at my channel for generics. Okay, so let's just go to the linked list and let's start building this out. As you can see, there are quite a lot of functions here, and you will find a lot more in the singly linked list. Once we build these out, you will understand the singly linked list file and the doubly linked list file also. Okay, so first of all, we want to create a linked list node. And why I'm not calling this a node, just simply the node? Well, basically because you might use node in other places in your code also. So that's why linked list node. I'm going to use a type alias in the linked list class, but we will get to that soon enough. Okay, so first of all, we need a value, and I'm going to make this public, so maybe you want to add this to a Swift package so you can use that throughout your project. So let's just have this as a public var and value. So that's our first thing. We have to have a value, and it will be of type T, of course. And then we want to have a next. So public var next, and that will be of type linked list node of type T. And of course, that will be optional because the tail, of course, doesn't have a next value. So linked list node of type T, and that is optional. And finally, we want to have a previous. Now, we are going to set this as a week. So public week var previous linked list node and T. And as you can see, we are going for a doubly linked list. And yeah, why not? Because this way you will better understand it. Okay, so let's just go with a public initializer init with a value of T. Okay, and then self.value equals our value. And that's our node. So we do have our linked list node ready with an initializer, our value, next and previous. And basically, that's all we need for our node. So right off here in the linked list, as you can see, it also conforms, it requires it of type T. So it is generic, which is really, really nice. Let's just have a type alias for our linked list node. So public type alias. I'm going to call this node because it's simpler. And then linked list node. Okay, so from now on, linked list node is just called not. Okay, so what do linked lists require? For a doubly linked list, we do require a head. Well, all of them are requiring a head and a tail. So I'm going to set this as private because you shouldn't be able to access the head nor the tail through the linked list. There should be other ways, and as you can see, we do have the first and the last. That is what we are going to access, the head and the tail. So private var head, and now I can just use not of type t and optional, and then again private var tail not of type t and optional. Okay, so we have kind of the basics. This is the minimum that is required from the linked list. So let's just go further and add in a few more stuff. So here you can see we might want to check if this is empty. So when do we know that this is empty? So we are going to append to the, well, actually, whenever the head is nil, then we do know that there aren't any elements in any nodes inside the linked list. So we want to return true or false according to the head's nil value. So if this is nil, then this is empty. So if head equals nil, then this is empty. Okay, first and last, let's just take care of those because they are really, really simple. So we want to return here our head and we want to return here our tail. Okay, so basically that's it. Now, those were pretty easy to understand. Now comes the harder part. So let's just append. So adding a new value to the head and for the next value and for the next node and so forth. So first of all, we want to create a new node. So let new node equals a node with the value of value, of course, that we want to add in there. Well, I want to append them. Now, there are a few cases here. So let's see if we do have a tail node. So if let tail node equals tail, then our new node, so we want to set up the previous for our new node as the tail node, and the tail node's next would be our new node. Basically, that's it. So new node dot previous equals new node, and then tail node dot next equals our new node. I think it's a little bit confusing at first, but think of the diagram that I have just shown you and think of what do we do when we want to insert when we do have a tail node. Otherwise, we do know that there aren't any nodes, so we just go head equals new node. Okay, and finally, the tail would be our new node. And basically, that's it. This is how we append. Now let's move forward and let's check our node at index. Now this will be a little bit more complicated, but I promise this is kind of the last interesting thing that I'm going to show you. Well, the last complicated thing that I'm going to show you. There are a lot of interesting things that I want to show you in this tutorial. So first of all, if the index is less than zero, then we will want to return nil. So we want to have if index is greater than or equals zero, then we want to do something else. We want to return nil. Okay, so right in here, if we do have kind of a valid index, we want to grab the head node, so var not equals our head. Okay, then we want to go var I equals index, and you will see why I'm just setting this up in just a second. So var right over there, and then we want to loop through the nodes while the node is, let me just write this out. So while Nod is not equal nil. And if I equals zero, then first of all, we want to return our nod because this is the first element, nod, okay. And we want to subtract one out of the I, and then we want to set nod equals nod next. Okay, and basically that's it. Now we can just return nod if the I is equal to zero. So yeah, you can just check this out and we will in just a second. So how do we remove or remove all? Well, let's just start off with the remove function. So first of all, we want to get the previous nod and the next nod. So let previous equals nod dot previous, and let next equals nod dot next. So if let previous equals previous, then we want to go previous next. I know it's a little bit confusing, but we are just setting the previous's next nod to be our next. That's why we wanted to grab the nod's next nod. And else we want to just go head equals next. Okay, so next up we want to go next dot previous equals previous. Okay, we also want to check if the next is nil. So if, let me just have this all the way up. So if next equals nil, there we go, next. I thought that there was something missing here. If next equals nil, then the tail will be our previous. So previous, okay. And otherwise we just go nod dot previous equals nil, nod next equals nil. So we just set those to nil and we want to return our nod's value. Great. Okay, so finally there is one left. And this is really, really simple. And that is how to remove all. Well, that is really, really easy. We just want to set the head to nil and our tail to nil. Okay, and basically that's it. And with these basic functions, now you have a basic linked list, but there's more to it. And you can find out more in the single linked list. I have this all commented and you can take a look at, we can pop, delete, last, remove. And I'm using actually a singly linked list in this content view. Let's just go to the content view model. As you can see, we can delete the last element and we can append. Now, this is a basic. You can take a look at all the other options that a singly linked list has. Well, in here, most probably there are a lot more, but this is more than enough. Go ahead and check that out. So I would just build and run this project. And again, we are using the singly linked list, not the one that we created. That is kind of the basics, so you better understand what linked lists are. But go ahead and check out singly linked list and doubly linked list from the resources. And yeah, let's just append. There we go. And now let's just delete the last. It's really, really nice. Okay, let's append again, delete. It's just working. Okay, and yeah, there you have it. Now you know how linked lists work, how you can create a linked list, and also in the resources you will find a more sophisticated linked list and a doubly linked list. Now if you do enjoy these types of video, go ahead and check out rebelloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet with me on a one-on-one 60-minute Zoom call where I can help you fixing bugs in your code or maybe learn Swift UI or Swift. Whatever is your problem with your iOS project, I can help you with. Yeah, most probably, I've been in this niche for 10 years now, so most probably I can help you with that. Again, it's at rebelloper.com/mentoring. I really like building out linked lists and using them in my own apps. And I hope you will too. So if you do like these videos, go ahead and hit that like button. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And while you're at it, make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. New videos like these ones. Go ahead and check them out. They are all about Swift UI, Swift in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.